So you build a new PC, but your monitor is not receiving any signal. If you're currently experiencing this one, let me show you a quick solution. Coming up. Hey, what's up guys, it's Mac here and we do a lot of tech related videos like this one. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing. With that said, let me show you the quick solution that I was talking about. There are only 3 reasons as why your newly built PC is not receiving any monitor signal. Number 1, PC parts incompatibility. Number 2, motherboard needs BIOS update. Number 3, you might have plugged your monitor incorrectly. Sounds basic, right? But trust me, there are some people who needs to hear it. Other than these reasons that we have here, I don't think that there is anything else unless some parts are faulty, but rarely happens on new products from out of the box. With this information, some of you might already know what to do, but for the rest of you who don't, just keep watching. So let's talk about PC parts incompatibility. Obviously, if your parts are not compatible, it will not work. First, let's check your parts. The first thing you need to know is whether your PC parts are really compatible or not. And the easiest way to check that is to go to pcpartpicker.com. Check the name of your PC parts by looking on the boxes of your build. Place those names, aka the name of your processor, motherboard, memory, your boot drive, video card, and the power supply. After doing so, you should look over here. You should see if it is compatible or not. If it is compatible, it will appear as a green color. But if not, you'll see a red one with a warning message saying, "These parts have potential issues or incompatibilities. See details below." Click the details link and see what is wrong. As for this build, it needs a BIOS update. Incompatibilities are different depending on the PC part choices and you just need to follow the instructions to fix your build. Also worth mentioning, if your PC doesn't have any graphics card installed, you should check if your processor has an integrated graphics feature. And again, look for your processor's name on the box. Google the name and add "have integrated graphics" with a question mark at the end. If your processor doesn't have a built-in graphics, then you can't make your PC work. The only solution for that is to buy yourself a new graphics card. If you're going to buy a new graphics card today, make sure you check out the link in the description below. For the latest, from the cheapest to the most expensive GPU available in the market as of the time we made this video. Moving on. Second reason that might cause your newly built PC not receiving a monitor signal is because it needed a BIOS update. Now, since your build is new, I highly recommend that you bring your newly built PC to the local shop where you got your PC parts from. Let them do this BIOS update for you. You might ask why. Well, updating the BIOS is a bothersome task. For instance, you need to know what is the latest and the correct BIOS for your motherboard to work with your processor. In some other cases, you'll be needing the previous generation processor to do this BIOS update. Well, I can go on and on, but you get the point. Also, if you're not familiar with the workaround of updating the motherboard BIOS, you could also mess it up. When I say mess it up, you could potentially destroy your new motherboard. How, you might ask? Because the BIOS updating process is crucial, and if in case there was a power interruption in the middle of the BIOS update, your motherboard will never work again. But if you let the PC store do the BIOS update for you and they mess it up, well, of course, your hands are clean and they are obligated to replace your motherboard. Anyway, after hearing all of these warnings and you still want to update your motherboard BIOS by yourself, I suggest visit PC Games N channel where they made a video on how to perform BIOS update using ASUS, MSI, and Gigabyte motherboards. Just check out the link in the description below and watch the video later. Third reason that's why your monitor is not receiving any signal from your PC is because you might have plugged the monitor into the wrong monitor input. Believe it or not, there are a lot of people who keep making this mistake, especially those first-time builders. How do I know? I answered a lot of comments in our troubleshooting tutorial videos of new builders plugging their monitor in the motherboard monitor input instead of their graphics card monitor input. So, this is the thing. If you got a graphics card installed in your PC, make sure you plug your monitor there, not in the motherboard monitor input. You'll only use the motherboard monitor input if you got no graphics card installed in your PC and if you're using the built-in graphics of your processor. Well, I guess that's all the information I can give you as of now. If you got other reasons with solution, of course, that will help the community here in this channel, please comment it down below. Also, if this video was able to help you in troubleshooting your PC, please share your experience with us in the comment section below. So that's it guys, if you found this video interesting and helpful, make sure you give us a thumbs up and share it. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.